When I was working for Bloomberg and NVIDIA, I interviewed hundreds of candidates for software engineering role. Based on that experience as an interviewer and my recent conversation with many who has cracked FAANG interviews, I have prepared a comprehensive study plan in case you're trying to get into big tech companies. So we are going to go over that plan step by step, right from resume preparation to job application to interviews to salary negotiation and accepting the offer. Many who apply in FAANG companies don't even get an interview call. Therefore, the first two stages of resume preparation and job application become super important. Talking about resume preparation, you need to keep few things in mind. Let's say you have a special achievement, such as you are an accepted contributor in Google Summer of Code. You need to highlight that achievement in first few lines of your resume. Now, people ask me, I don't have any achievement. What should I do? Well, you can try to get some special achievement by doing open source contribution, competing in coding competition, and doing community contributions such as participating on Stack Overflow, contributing to various Discord servers. My own channel has a Discord server. All these things will help you get this first line that you need for your resume, and your resume will be different from thousands of applications that these companies are receiving. When you're talking about your prior experience or even college projects, make sure you use STAR method to describe that project. STAR is basically situation, task, action, and result. By looking at this diagram, you will get an idea. So you are trying to say, what impact did you create in this project? You have to use proofs over vague statements. When I receive resumes and when I say excellent English communication, that doesn't impress me at all. Everyone writes that, right? What is the proof? Okay, you are a secretary of Toastmaster Club, or you spoke in Pi Data event. These are the proofs. And in order to build these proofs, you have to work hard, right? So you have to get out, participate in different activities so that you can mention those things on your resume. When people mention their hobbies, let's say instead of reading books, you can say which books you like. So this way you are giving concrete details. You're giving sort of like a proof that you do like reading the book. And many times the recruiter who is reading your resume, maybe they have a common interest. Maybe they're reading the same book and you got a topic of the conversation. All in all, you should keep your resume only single page. I have looked at resumes of 20 years experience folks, and they write beautiful one-page resume. So if 20-year experienced person can do this, you can do it definitely. I have made a detailed video. If you go to YouTube, search for Code Basic Resume Tips, you'll find this video. Although it says data analyst, the tips which we have discussed are applicable to software engineer as well. So go over those tips, and in the video description, I have given few resume templates that you can use for your own resume. All right, you have prepared your resume and you are ready to apply for a job. People have this inferiority complex that they are from tier 3 college, or they have 10 years of experience in some service-based company. Therefore, they should not be applying for FAANG companies. But the fact is that getting job in FAANG and pretty much any other product-based companies is not as hard as you think it is. It all depends on your attitude and how you are preparing. For job application, the best way is always the job referral. So let's say if you know your college senior or someone in your network who is already working for that company, and if they do a referral, there is a high chance you will get an interview call. Now let's say you don't know anyone who is working for Google or Microsoft and you want to go work for that company, try to build connection with people through LinkedIn, through technical conferences. You go attend conferences, build connection with people, or build connection with people on LinkedIn. Now, making connection with people on LinkedIn is an art, and there is a whole science behind it. And that's a topic for some other day, but you can Google it, watch some videos on how to basically win friends and influence people so that when you need a job referral, there is someone in your network who is ready to help. Simplify.jobs is another portal where you can almost do like a matchmaking, like shaadi.com, where you specify your criteria, which technology you want to work in, what is your salary, bunch of other criteria, and it will tell you matching jobs. See, FAANG companies means 5 or 6 companies. There are actually many other companies, product-based companies like Square, Affirm, so many companies where they offer more salary than FAANG companies and more better culture, better learning opportunities, things like that. So don't think you have option of joining only these five big companies. There are so many other companies as well. And simplify.jobs will show you all those job opportunities, and you can apply for those jobs with a click. So job application becomes very, very easy when you're using this portal. This is something that Jamin Brumbert used when he was looking for a job, and he eventually got a job at Meta. Most crucial part of the whole process is going to be coding interview. And not only for freshers, even when they hire senior engineers or engineering managers, they ask coding questions. And you all know, for coding questions, Lead Code and Gig for Gigs are the two best platforms that you can use to practice. On Lead Code, there are more than 2000 questions. So there are 75 curated questions called Grand 75, and you can use 8 weeks time period to prepare for these questions. And these questions will cover variety of data structures and algorithms, such as C, array, binary search, tree, and so on. So these are like 75 golden questions from Lead Code that you can do preparation on. And as it's mentioned here, you can take 8 weeks. Every week you do like 10 questions, which is pretty much doable. Even if you're working, let's say you spend 1 hour every day, on weekend you spend 4 to 5 hours. Within 8 weeks, you would be done with 75 questions, and that is gonna be a gold mine for you. This is the resource that Jamin Brumbert, again, he used it for his Meta job interviews. I have received so many testimonials for my own data structure and algorithm playlist. Here I have mentioned few testimonials. I have many more, but these folks get a job at Meta, Walmart, Microsoft, and so on. And they all tagged me in their LinkedIn post, and they were referring to data structure and algorithm playlist that I have on YouTube. It is free playlist. So if you search for it, you will find videos on arrays, hash map, LinkedIn, graph, pretty much all the data structures and algorithm. I might add a few more videos, but if you look at any video, this will have coding and exercise both. So I'm giving a very intuitive explanation and also giving an exercise, so that whatever practice, whatever problem you learn, you can practice on it. And by the way, there is a Hindi data structure algorithm tutorial playlist as well, just in case you're interested in a Hindi playlist. The other resource is Take You Forward YouTube channel. Raj Vikramaditya is a Google engineer, and he has solved many problems on competitive coding. So please refer to this. My friend was telling me, I don't know, I have not seen any videos on that channel, but my friend likes this person. That's why I'm referring to him. BigOCheatSheet.com is another resource which can help you quickly grasp the Big O complexity of different data structures and algorithms. Now, Big O complexity is something you can't avoid during the interview. In coding interview, they will ask for this. So having a handy reference of complexities for different algorithms and data structures is going to be super useful. In YouTube, if you search Code Basics FAANG, you will find a video where I interviewed Prasad, who cracked job interviews in 10 different companies, including some FAANG companies such as Microsoft, Facebook, and Amazon. In this video, he has shared the wisdom of how do you approach the interview. Obviously, this guy has mastered the art of cracking coding interviews, and he has shared all of that wisdom in this video. No wonder why it received more than 500,000 views. I'm going to share a few tips from that video. Number one is, solving 2000 questions on Lead Code alone is not going to help you. In the interview, they're looking for your approach. They're not looking for just the absolute answers, okay? So when I interview people, I sometimes present a vague problem, and I want to see if they're asking clarifying questions and if they're using critical thinking to solve a problem with my help, right? So many times it is like, you cannot solve the problem alone, but you can solve the problem with interviewer's help. This is a very different way of thinking. You know, in the interview, when people go, they think you versus me, but no, use the interviewer's help to solve the problem and do a friendly conversation. Communicate well. use the hints that interviewer is giving you wisely and try to solve the problem. Don't be nervous, be calm, don't make mistakes by over preparing for the interview. Mock interviews are very effective to prepare you for the actual round. Nowadays, I'm seeing in many colleges, the professor will help you with mock interviews. You can also ask your seniors who are already working in the industry to conduct the mock interview for you. If you can afford money, there are many platforms like interviewing.io, prem.com. I have not used this platform myself, so don't take these as my own suggestion. What I'm suggesting is do mock interviews as much as you can before going for the actual round, because you will get lot of critical feedback on your communication style, whether you can describe your resume projects properly or not. See, if you don't do mock interviews, at least you can do recording, voice recording, and try to describe your resume projects. And when you hear to that voice recording, you will get an idea if you're using a lot of filler words or if you're describing your resume projects with enough clarity and so on. So do mock interviews, do your own voice recording so that you are very well prepared before you go for the actual interview. The other tip I want to share is using Python instead of Java and C++ in the coding round. The reason I'm saying is that when I was interviewing at Bloomberg, I noticed many candidates, they use Python and they were getting unfair advantage because Python has a very compact code syntax. So you don't have to remember a lot of things. If you have to write, let's say 5 lines of code in Java, same thing can be done in Python in 1 line of code. So see, you are in a very intense environment of an interview and you don't have to memorize things and you have to write less lines of code just because you are using this Python language. On my own portal, codebasics.io, I have this Python course at a very affordable price. And I'm using very easy to understand explanations so that learning Python sounds like a child's play. We are also using project-based learning. So learn Python if you don't know that already. And I have some data analytics and few other courses as well. Planning to launch more courses. So check out codebasics.io. If you are an experienced candidate, you will have a system design coding round where they ask questions such as design Twitter, design Facebook feed, etc. You can practice these interview questions on a famous YouTube channel by Gaurav Sen, where he explains, you know, how to design WhatsApp, for example, how to design Instagram and so on. And his videos are very popular. You can watch these videos, learn system design. Another resource is System Design Primer, where there is a GitHub page and you can scroll down, look at system design, object-oriented design question. For example, here we are talking about design Twitter. Okay, and you can go through the solution. By the way, don't go through the solution directly. Try to work on that solution on your own. This is super duper important. If you look at the solution, your mind is biased and you can't prepare well. All right, you want to get a job in FAANG companies, you do preparation on your own. First attempt should be your own genuine attempt and then only look at the solution. The other round that they usually have is behavioral interview. Now, in companies like Square, for example, they call it a leadership interview, which is mainly for experienced folks, but general behavior questions are asked even within the coding interview. You know, they're trying to check your attitude and check your behavior in. So it's important that you prepare for behavioral questions. Again, techinterviewhandbook.org website has a nice collection of the most commonly asked questions. They also have company specific questions. For example, here there are Amazon specific behavioral questions. So if you prepare for all these questions, they're going to be very, very helpful. If you're talking about Amazon, they ask this Amazon leadership principle question. So if you don't know about it, just Google Amazon leadership principles. You will find the core values that they have when you talk about leadership, and having good understanding of these values are going to be very useful. When you go for an interview, make sure you study that company, their products, clients, their culture and so on. That way it looks like you're not there just to get another job or for money. You really care about working in that company. You care about the core values and so on. So preparing for those values is as important as preparing for your coding round. Now, many companies give interview material in advance. For example, here in US, if you apply in Facebook, they will send you all the material, including mock interviews conducted by Facebook engineers. So there'll be two Facebook engineers who will be doing mock interview, and they send you this video. So before going for an interview, if you watch the video, you will get some preparation in terms of what you expect out of that interview round. So if you're getting such an email with all the resources, make sure you study them really well. Let's say you passed all the hurdles and now you got a job offer. There comes salary negotiation. Now, many people don't even negotiate salary. They will take whatever is given to them. But don't do that mistake. You can always negotiate salaries. And there are websites like levels.fyi. They give you an idea on how much salary every company is offering. For example, Microsoft senior engineer, they get this much. And this is the data from people posting their real salaries. There could be some fake salaries, but majority of them are kind of trustworthy. And you can also use their negotiation services, okay? So let's say you don't know the art of negotiation. You can get negotiation coaching. So on website like levels.fyi, if you go to services, click on negotiation coaching, you pay some money, but let's say if by negotiating, if you get 10, 20 lakh rupees of raise, then why not, correct? So negotiation is something that programmers are not good at. And if you get some coaching, it's gonna be helpful anyway. All these resources are available on my GitHub page. The link of this page is in video description below. So it, you know, shows you a summary of the entire process. So we talked about resume prep, job application, three type of interviews, salary negotiation, and job offer acceptance. I also mentioned the key resources, right? For coding, lit code, gigs for gigs are the main one. Tech interview handbook, let me show you this website. So tech interview handbook, we talked about Grind 75 here, and there are a lot of useful resources on this particular website. We talked about using YouTube, right? Couple of YouTube channels, my own data structure algorithm playlist, Take You Forward, Goros, and so on. And I have prepared the list of all these resources which you can use. And you can also share it with your friends who are looking for interview guidance. And thanks to all these LinkedIn posts. See, I talked about all these LinkedIn posts of people getting jobs in FAANG companies. And my playlist was one of the resources, but they mentioned few other resources. So I'm going to give a link of this LinkedIn playlist. These links are available here. Watch this particular interview. If you click on this one, for example, this interview is full of interview wisdom, okay? 600,000 views, there is a reason. And if you can read the comment, read it. I mean, it just tells you the quality of the wisdom that is shared by my good friend Prasad in this video. All right, again, I want to say that cracking interviews in FAANG companies is not a rocket science nowadays. So be very, very confident, prepare with a discipline, make a study plan. If you want to do it in a group, go to my Discord server. So if you check my video description, I have Discord servers where you can make, you can have partners who are searching for jobs together and make buddies or group and prepare in a group rather than preparing alone. And when you're preparing in a group, the other person can help you with a mock interview, resume review, and so on. And that is very effective way of preparing. I wish you all the best. If you have any question, post in a comment box below. And if you know anyone who is preparing for big tech companies interviews, please share this video with them along with this GitHub link. I wish you all the best.